Children, now let me continue. Already in the previous class we have seen what is motion. Motion is what I said, it's a movement. That is the distance, that is the from, for example, particle A moves from A to B. So before that it was in the position of A, now it goes to B. So this is known as what? Motion. And what are the kinds of motion? Four kinds of motion. What are the four kinds of motion I said? Let me recollect everything. There are four kinds of motion. Linear motion, circular motion, oscillatory motion, and then random motion. All the four motions, I said what it is. Then we have seen based on the speed, we have seen what is uniform motion, what is non-uniform motion. We have drawn the graph also for that. And then what are the differences between distance and displacement? In the distance, it is the actual distance traveled by the object is known as distance. Displacement, the actual distance only, but it shows the direction. So it's a scalar quantity. Distance is the scalar quantity. Displacement is vector quantity. Okay, we have seen all those things very clearly. And what are the sub constituents of the motion? That is time, speed, time, distance traveled. That is what is speed, distance traveled by time taken. Everything we have just analyzed in the previous class. Now we have to see what are the equations of the motion. Based on the equations, we have based on the motions, Newton, he made three motion equation. What are the thing we will see? Newton studied the motion of an object and gave a set of three motions. So what are the three equations? We will see now. First equation is V is equal to u plus a t. Second equation is s is equal to u t plus of a t squared. And third equation is v squared is equal to u squared plus 2s. First you must know what is what. Here u stands for initial velocity. And v, final velocity. And t is time taken. And a is acceleration. And S is displacement distance. So whatever the object may be, it will start with the starting speed is known as what? U. That is initial velocity. So it reaches to the, it takes certain time. The time is known as what? T. And A is acceleration, that is increase the speed is known as acceleration. S is what I said, displacement at distance taken, ut into of a t squared. T squared means time doubled. And v squared, that is final velocity you have to find out, means u squared plus 2as. By using the formula, we can find out what is velocity, what is displacement, and what is velocity acceleration. V squared means what? Acceleration, or we are finding out. These are the three equations. And we will go for one calculation. It is given in page number 20. The brake applied to a car to produce an acceleration of 6 meters squared in the opposite direction of the motion. The car is just moving on. What is the speed it is? 6 meters squared in 1 second. he put the brake. So maybe some other disturbances in the opposite side, he put the brake. If the car takes 2 seconds to stop after the application of brake, after the application of brake means what? He applied the brake, then to the car immediately does not stop. It takes two seconds and then finally it reaches, it comes to the rest. So what's the question here? Calculate the distance traveled by the time. Travel by the time means after applying the brake, how much distance traveled by car. Then we have to see for the solution now. A is equal to, that is acceleration is equal to minus 6 meter by second squared acceleration. Acceleration squared only, no. Next, time is equal to, after 2 seconds only it stops. And final velocity is equal to 0. From the equation of motion, we have to say V is equal to, first equation you have taken, V is equal to U plus AT. Here V is equal to, V is equal to 0. 0 is equal to U plus AT. A is what? Minus 6. T is 2 seconds. Clear? Next, 0 U plus into minus, minus 6 2s are 12. Clear? Then S is equal to displacement. What time it travels? I say no. What is S? UT plus half AT squared. S is equal to UT. Already we are finding out UT is what? 12. U is 12 we have seen. U is 12, minus 12. T is 2. Plus half. A is minus 6 into t squared, 2 into 2. Children, it is the thing given from the question we have taken it. This is the equation. V is equal to U plus AT. Then we have to find out U. U is not given to us. We have to find out. So A is minus 6, T is 2, 6 into 2, 12. So U is equal to minus 12. And S is equal to, what's the formula there? UT plus AT squared, half AT squared. U already we are finding out 12, T is 2 seconds, then plus half, it's a number given there. A is equal to what? Minus 6, and T is equal to 2, 2 squared, 2 into 2. Okay, so 12 2s are 24. S is equal to 24 plus 6 2s are 12, 12 2s are 24, 24 divided by 12 to 12. 24 plus into minus 12 is equal to 12 meters. So after the brake applied, the car stops in after 12 meters. Clear? Is it clear for you? Any doubt in this? U, we are multiplying and taking the value of U, and A and all given there itself. A is what I said, minus 6 into half AT squared, T squared, minus 6 is the A, and U is 12. We are finding out by substituting the values clearly, and we got the answer. That is, the car, after applied the brake, it travels how many meters? 12 meters. So how we are dividing this? 6 2s are 12, 12 2s are 24, half. So you have to cancel by 2. Clear? Already you would have come across this kind of sums and all in max. So like that we are verifying the equation. So from the, then other one activity is the, suppose you are standing in a top place and you are throwing off a small eraser and a stone. Two objects you have taken. One is eraser, other one is stone. You are throwing it, that both from the top it drops into the earth same time only. What are the things you have taken? Stone and eraser. both are falling to the ground, both are reaching the ground in the same time. First time you are taking stone and eraser. Both are reaching the time in the same time only. Okay, yeah. In the second act, second time you have taken a small eraser and a sheet of paper. Eraser and paper. Which will come first? Eraser, then paper. First, what will be? First, eraser. Eraser will come first. Second, what? Paper. The third time you have taken equal weight of the paper. Papers only same size and same thing. One is crushed into crushed, other one is as it is. Which is reached first? The crushed paper will reach first. And the paper will reach last. The first, you are taking stone and eraser, both are reaching at the same time only. This because this is, suppose if you are throwing all in the absence of, this is because of air. Because of the air, they are disturbed. Air is the material medium. Because of the air, they are disturbed. So stone and eraser, both are solid substances. So they dropped in the same time only they have taken. In the case of second one is eraser, other one is paper. Eraser is heavier than paper. Air disturbs. Air enters into that because of air activity only. The eraser will be first and paper will be second. Third, you have taken paper as well as both the papers are same size, same weight, everything. But one you are crushing it, other one is paper as it is you are throwing. Crushed paper only will reach the earth first, then paper. This shows in the empty place, all the thing, even stone, eraser, paper, everything you are throwing together means all will reach in the same place, same time only. That is vacuum. Empty means what I said? Vacuum. The vacuum you are throwing, if you are going to the place where there is no air at all, if you are throwing all the three, stone, eraser and paper, they will reach the earth in the same time, simultaneously. Whereas, here it changes because air. So, air plays a major role in the activities of motion. Clear? So from this we have to find out centripetal acceleration and centripetal force. You know, earth has the gravitational force. By using the gravitational force, a body is said to be accelerated. Accelerated means what? Body is just said to be changed its motion. So a body is said to be accelerated if the velocity of the body changes either in magnitude or in direction. So we say the body increases its speed. The increasing in speed is known as what? Acceleration. This is because it changes, because of that the body changes its position. So the motion of a stone in this, for example, you are taking, it's a stone you are taking in a stone, you are tying in the thread and you are throwing like that. Okay, yeah. The stone just wrinkles and finally, then after that you are roping, you are tying the stone in the rope and you are throwing like this. You are making of like that, whirling. And finally you reach the rope, the stone will go to the direction where the force goes. So from that only we can find out what is centripetal acceleration. The speed comes from because of the object changes position. And the acceleration edanala varudhen sonna, adoda object it changes. Before that it was whirling, now we are making it to move. Because it changes its position, acceleration is increased and the stone falls into the different direction where the rubber band lies down. Okay, this acceleration is known as centripetal acceleration and the force is known as centripetal force. This is due to the acceleration of, due to the gravitational force. So magnitude, then you know what is centripetal force and what are the things we have come across now? That is equation of motions, Newton, based on the observing the motion of an object, and he has derived three laws, that is three motions, equation of motions. What are the three equations? U is equal to V is equal to U plus AT. Here V is final velocity, U is initial velocity, A is acceleration, T is time taken. that S is equal to displacement, that is equal to UT into half AT square. V square final velocity, that is U square plus 2A's, 2AS. I said what are the definition, and we did the experiment on calculation also. Now we said if you are throwing the things in the vacuum, either it is heavier object or lighter object, they will reach to the earth in the same time only. Whereas if the air acts in that, air is the medium which acts on the object, that acceleration will be disturbed. For example, I said three things. What are the things you have taken? First time you have taken stone and eraser. Because both are heavier substance, they reach to the earth. Eraser, paper, third one paper, same weight of paper only, but one is crushed form, other one is the plain form. Okay, yeah. And we have seen centripetal force and centripetal acceleration. Now we have to go for one more calculation. So 900 kilogram of car moving at 10 meters second, problem 4. Okay, yeah. It takes 10 round around a circle with radius of 25 centimeter. Here the formula is, let me do there. This activity sums and I'll work out and see. Suppose in case it comes, it will be useful to you. So solution we have to see. A is equal to, acceleration is equal to V squared by R. So A is equal to, you are given already 10 squared. You are taking the numbers from there. So your 10 squared means 10 into 10, 100. Here by 25, 4 meters second. Okay, yeah. Then net force of the thing is F is equal to MA, that is mass into acceleration. The car weight is what? 900. Acceleration is 4. 900 into 4, 3600 Newton. N is enough. 3600 Newton. Okay, so this lesson over. So what are the things we come across? This lesson, short lesson it is. Simple lesson only. So we have seen what is rest, what is motion, and what are the types of motion? Four types of motion I said. Based on the position, we can say uniform and non-uniform. We are presenting a graph for that. And we have seen what is distance, what is displacement. What are the differences between distance and displacement, I said very clearly. And what are the qualities of the motion? Speed, velocity, acceleration. And Newton, how many equations he gave? Based on the motion he gave, 3 equations. I said what are the 3 equations? And we are finding out, so 2 calculations based on the equation. And you know what is centripetal force and what is centripetal acceleration. And thus the lesson completes. These are the points we have discussed today. So 2 more course sums we did. So exercise sums and all, that is example sums, what is did in the book, you have to go through properly. Question and answers we will give in another class. Thank you, children.